from the studios of Adventist World Radio in Pune.
Hello and a very warm welcome to our International English Service.
Join us on our program today with music coming to you from Candace Johnson and Heritage Singers.
A story on the carpenter's glasses.
Followed by a health talk on bee stings.
Ending our program with a thought from God's Word on the topic, God cares for you personally. I'm Anita.
I'm Sharad.
And you're listening to Adventist World Radio, the voice of hope.
We begin our program with a song, Can You Reach My Friend?
You heard a song by Candace Johnson on Adventist World Radio. And now over to our friend Diamond for the story on the carpenter's glasses.
My grandfather worked as a carpenter. On this particular day, he was building some crates for the clothes his church was sending to an orphanage in China. On his way home, he reached into his shirt pocket to find his glasses, but they were gone. When he mentally replayed his earlier actions, he realized what happened. The glasses had slipped out of his pocket unnoticed and fallen into one of the crates, which he had nailed shut. His brand new glasses were heading for China. The Great Depression was at its height, and Grandpa had 6 children. He had spent $20 for those glasses that very morning. He was upset by the thought of having to buy another pair. "It's not fair," he told God as he drove home in frustration. "I've been very faithful in giving my time and money to your work, and now this." Several months later, the director of the orphanage was on furlough in the United States. He wanted to visit all the churches that supported him in China. So he came to speak one Sunday at my grandfather's small church in Chicago. The missionary began by thanking the people for their faithfulness in supporting the orphanage. "But most of all," he said, "I must thank you for the glasses you sent last year. You see, the communists had just swept through the orphanage, destroying everything, including my glasses. I was desperate. Even if I had the money, there was simply no way of replacing those glasses. Along with not being able to see well, I had headaches every day. So my co-workers and I prayed about this. And then your crates arrived. When my staff opened the covers, they found a pair of glasses lying on top." The missionary paused long enough to let his words sink in. Then, still gripped with the wonder of it all, he continued, "Folks, when I tried on the glasses, it was as though they were made for me. I want to thank you for being a part of that." The people listened, happy for the miraculous glasses, but the missionary surely must have confused their church with another, they thought. There were no glasses on their list of items to be sent overseas. But sitting quietly in the back, with tears streaming down his face, an ordinary carpenter realized that the master carpenter had used him in an extraordinary way.
Thank you, Diamond, for a nice story. And now before you hear a song, here's a health talk on bee stings presented by Anupam.
A bee sting is relatively harmless to most people. Although the sting produces pain, swelling, redness, and itching, no serious damage is usually done. There are 2 exceptions, however. One is when a person gets many stings at the same time, even those not usually affected can become ill if stung repeatedly by several bees. Second, some people react negatively to the venom in a bee sting and become seriously ill. The venom is poisonous. An edema in the air passage above the vocal cords may even cause death. When a bee stings, the first task is to get the stinger out. Remove it carefully. The stinger contains the venom sac, and pinching it may empty more venom into your body. Tweezers and fingernails are not the things to use to get a stinger out. Instead, scrape the stinger off gently with a knife blade or loosen it with a needle or pin so you can remove the stinger sideways. Ease it out slowly so you won't squeeze more of the poison into your tissues. If you're sure you have been stung by a hornet or wasp, don't look for a stinger. There won't be one. Since wasps and hornets don't leave a stinger behind, they can sting repeatedly. So if you're certain you have been stung more than once by the same insect, you're not being stung by the bee, and you won't find a stinger. The next step is to soak the sting in a solution of Epsom salts. Dissolve as many crystals of Epsom salts in the water as you can. If you know that a victim is allergic to bee stings, call a physician immediately or take him to the emergency room of the closest hospital. The person will also find it easier to breathe if he is kept in a half-sitting, half-lying position. You may also place a firm bandage around the arm or leg which was stung. This bandage will help prevent the spread of the offending substance. Be careful not to wrap the bandage too tightly. If the person complains of a lack of circulation in the arm or leg, loosen the bandage. Sensitivity to bee stings is really a sensitivity to protein. The effective treatment of protein sensitivity is by the injection of a dilute solution of the drug epinephrine just below the surface of the skin. This injection should be given under the direction of a physician or a nurse because it's very easy to give too large a dose. A series of these injections may be needed over a 2 or 3 day period. If you know you're allergic to bee stings, it might be worthwhile to ask your physician about a desensitization treatment as a preventative measure. It could easily mean the difference between a little pain and a serious health crisis, or even death.
That was Anupam with Health Talk on AWR. For more details about our program, you could write to us on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
Time now for another song, Jesus, We Just Want to Thank You, by Heritage Singers.
We just want to thank you. Thank you for being so good. Jesus, we just want to praise you. Jesus, we just want to praise you. Jesus, we just want to praise you. Praise you for being so good. God is so
Bible theme today is God Cares for You Personally. This message will be presented to you by Edison Samraj.
God is far too great for us to fully understand. He has no beginning, he has no end. There is no place where his presence is not felt. The Bible asks in Job 11:7, can you fathom the mysteries of God? Can you probe the limits of the Almighty? God lives in the heaven and he rules over the whole earth. And the Bible says, this is what the Lord says, heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool, Isaiah 66:1. God reigns over the nations. God is seated on his holy throne, Psalms 47:8. We are going to study today how we can look at the special truths about God and how these facets about God's unchanging character can change you. Through these, you will understand more of what God is like, and you will come to understand God and how much he cares for you. He cares for you. He cares for you personally. So it is our privilege this time to study what God is like. God is the creator of everything that you see in this universe. He created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. You alone are the Lord who made the heaven, even the highest heavens, and all the starry host, the earth and all that is on it, the seas and all that is in them. You give life to everything, and the multitudes of heaven worship you. So God is the creator of everything. And if he is the creator God, he has a purpose and plan. And therefore he cares for you as a person. God is not only the creator of everything, he is all powerful. He is all powerful. He is so powerful that he can do anything he wants. For who hath resisted his will? Hath not the potter power over the clay? Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the majesty and the splendor, for everything in heaven and in earth is yours. Yours, O Lord, is the kingdom. You are exalted as a head over all. Now to him who is able to do immeasurable more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, Ephesians 3:20. So God is an all-powerful God. We have seen in those three verses that was just read. He is so powerful, yet he personally cares for you. He can do powerful things in your life. He can create circumstances that are power-giving. He can create a power within you to make you powerful. Not only is he powerful, he is all-knowing. Nothing in creation is hidden from God's sight. Everything is uncovered and laid bare before the eyes of him. To him we must give account. Hebrews 4:13. God is greater than our hearts and he knows everything about your life. Did you know this? God knows everything about you. He knows your secrets. He knows your plans. He knows your intentions. He knows your ideas. He knows what you are planning to do. You can't hide anything from God, my brothers and sisters. God knows everything about you and he cares for you personally. God is holy. There is no one holy like the Lord. There is no one besides you. There is no rock like our God. 1 Samuel 2:2. God is a spirit and his worshippers must worship him in spirit and in truth. God is a person whom you can know. Come near to him and he will come near to you. The Lord is near to all who call upon him and to all who call on him in truth. And most importantly, God is a loving Father. How great is the love of the Father has lavished on us that we should be called the children of God, sons and daughters of God. And that is what we are. 1 John 3:1. My brothers and sisters, we have a God who is a creator of everything. He is so powerful. He is all-knowing. He is holy. He is a spirit. He is a person whom you can know. And he is a loving Father. We are created by him, my brothers and sisters. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful, I know that well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in that secret place. So God has created us so wonderfully. Look at yourself. Look at your personality, your mind, your body, and your entire organs of the body were created by God. When I was woven together in the depths of the sea, your eyes saw my unformed body, and all the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to me. Beautiful thoughts. God has created us. He owns us. Do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. You were bought at a price. Therefore, honor God with your body. God created your body to honor him. We are called to worship God. You are worthy, O Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being. Revelation 4:11. So it's a beautiful experience today to know this wonderful God who is creating us and owning us and calling us to worship him. And Jesus is making a claim. He is making a statement today about himself. But he also wants us to make a decision. Jesus said, love thy God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. The Bible tells us about a man called Joshua. He was a great leader of the nation of Israel. The people had been wandering for 40 years in the wilderness without a land of their own. Under Joshua's direction and the Lord's leadership, they led them to victory against evil nations living in Canaan and possessed their land for the homeless nation of Israel. Joshua then challenged all the people to make a decision. At that point, he said, choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve, whether the gods of your forefathers served beyond the river or the God of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Very clear statement Joshua made to the children of Israel. The same challenge comes to each one of you today. Will you make that same commitment as Joshua did on that day? Here is an opportunity for you to make a decision. This day I give my worship to the only true God of heaven and earth and surrender my will, my life, my possessions to him. From this day I determine never to worship any other gods. My worship is for him only, and I will teach other truths about God. If that is your commitment today, join with me in prayer. Father in heaven, I thank you, Lord, for this wonderful truth about yourself. You are a great God. You care for us. You understand us. You are so wonderful. You are so personal to us. And we thank you for being a holy God, a spiritual God, a God who is a loving Father. And Lord, we know that you have created us. We know that we are owned by you. And we are called to worship you today. Because you receive glory and honor and power from your created beings. We are your children, Father. We are your sons and daughters. We want to choose this day that we will serve you, we will commit our lives to you, and we live for you, and we will worship you in truth and in spirit. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayers. Bless every listener to come near to you and believe you and come closer to your truth every day of their lives. Bless them, Lord, to know you more and become acquainted with your love for them every moment of their lives. Give them courage and confidence in your word, in your truth, and in your love. May your grace be sufficient for them. This is my prayer in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Thank you, Edison Samraj, for sharing God's word.
You are listening to the Voice of Hope from Pune, India.
We trust that you've been blessed with our program.
The word of God says, give all your worries and cares to God, for he cares about what happens to you. And that's found in 1 Peter 5 verse 7. Friends, God protects, provides, and preserves us now and forever. Isn't it a great promise to be renewed for our lives today? Well, to know more on God's word, we would love to receive your letters on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
Our address once again is Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India. I'm Sharad.
And I'm Manita, signing out from Adventist World Radio.
Be sure to listen again along with your family and friends.
Until then, we wish you good health and a happy home.
Goodbye and God bless you.